say like, oh, he's an actuary, and they make it sound like I'm this special human being. And I just think of myself as a regular person. So I think it's kind of funny when people think I'm like, oh, an actuary, like I'm not a genie, like I'm not, like I'm just human like everyone else.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is another episode of the series, Get to Know an Actuary. So in this series, I will interview different actuaries and actuarial professionals with many different backgrounds, such as pricing, valuation, consulting, risk, and so on. So my name is Dee. I am a qualified actuary, and I'm currently working in the risk function in a life insurance company in Canada. So I started this channel to document my life journey and also to share different experiences and lessons with the goal is to help you study smarter, work better, and live happier. So I am very excited to introduce you to Mike, who is a marketing actuary. Hi, Mike. Thanks for being here today.
Hi, Dee.
Mike, can you tell us about yourself?
My name's Mike Stinchcombe. I'm from the great city of Windsor, Ontario, Canada, born and raised. And I left Windsor when I started my first full-time job outside of university. I now work as a marketing actuary for one of Canada's top insurance firms. And I got my FSA in 2016.
Why did you choose to become an actuary? How did your actuarial career path get started?
Great question. I actually went to university for chemistry, and I loved the people in chemistry. I loved the subject, but I didn't really like the careers that chemistry led to. I worked in a lab, and I just found it very isolating. I was always by myself, and it felt like the same thing over and over every day. So when I graduated, I was looking for something more on the business side that combined my love for analysis and mathematics. And my dad actually went to Western for math back in the day, and he contemplated going into actuarial science, wrote a couple of the exams. So he was always telling me like, you should write these exams. And I'm like, I don't know what actuarial science is, like get out of my room kind of thing, like every normal teenager. But eventually, like just to kind of get him off my back, I said that I would try it out and see if I liked it. And I knew basically right away that it was exactly what I was looking for. You get to solve real world problems, but using math for it. So I wrote a couple of exams, and then once you've written a couple, then you want to do a couple more, and then you're just stuck. Like you kind of, you should keep going, I guess. And yeah, and that's kind of how I got started in the actuarial industry. It was almost on accident. I kind of just did it to make my parents happy. And I hate admitting that they were right, but they were right. And I should have listened to them back in the day, I guess.
I'm sure your dad is very happy to hear that. And it is a happy incident for sure.
Yeah.
So how did you decide between SOA, the Societal Actuaries, and CAS, the Casualty Actuarial Society?
Yeah, so this one's actually kind of funny, because when you get started, you just start Googling things about actuarial science, and the SOA just has a lot of information when you Google like actuarial exams for students. So I just found a lot of information on their website, and I kind of just started writing their recommended path and then looking for jobs in the insurance industry. To be honest, I didn't really know that there was like a separate whole society for CAS until I think like I started my full-time job, and people would ask like, oh, why did you choose SOA over CAS? And I think my answer was, I don't know what the CAS is. So that's kind of how I got into the whole SOA side. Also, I got hired at an insurance company, so I don't, like, they probably wouldn't like me writing CAS exams when everyone else does the SOA track. So it just kind of happened, I guess.
This is a perfect example of how marketing can be very powerful, because clearly it influenced your decision and also your life career.
So powerful. And I think like a lot of my answers will be about the marketing side of actuarial science. And yeah, it's something that I'm a big believer in, is how well you market is definitely how you're going to get the best results.
As a marketing actuary, can you describe a little bit about your work?
For sure. So I guess my answer kind of changes pre and post COVID. So pre COVID, I used to travel around Canada. I would work with advisors and wholesalers across the country on helping them with actuarial concepts, teaching them about our products, telling them how our products do in competitive situations against some of our competitors, presenting at industry conferences or at conferences, at smaller little like advisor conferences, teaching them about things, or helping people with cases. People would call me up. I would jump on video calls. Sometimes I would even be at their meeting in person just to help out. Post-COVID, obviously, I haven't traveled anywhere since February, so it's been a little different. However, my day-to-day is still pretty similar. I still get a lot of phone calls. I'm hopping on whatever case I'm working on that day. So it's kind of just, you never know what each day is going to bring, which is something I really enjoy about my role. There's pros and cons to both sides. I really enjoyed the traveling aspect of my job. I feel like you make a stronger personal connection with your clients, with advisors, if you're sitting across the table from them compared to on a Zoom call. However, there has been benefits. Like, I don't have to fly across the country. I'm not getting stuck in the airport. Sometimes I feel like I live in the airport. I think this has been the longest I've been stuck in my house in one time. Like, I don't think I've ever spent more than a week in my house since I started as a marketing actuary. So yeah, it's been different, but you adapt and you learn how your role changes depending on what's going on in the world.
So what do you like about the work of being an actuary? How about something that you do not quite like or enjoying and or find challenging?
So for what I really enjoy, just solving problems and helping people. And when you're doing the work, you know, it's actually being used for a specific reason. I think that was part of what drew me to actuarial science over chemistry. Was chemistry, you would work on something, but like you didn't really know what it was doing. Like, how does this apply to the real world? And it does have real world applications. I just think the jobs that I was in, it seemed more theoretical and I didn't really like that part of it. Where with AXI, like if I'm helping out on a case, there's actually a client that I'm helping or benefiting. Teaching an advisor, they're going to use the knowledge you pass on to them to explain to their clients. So that's the part I enjoy about it most, is just genuinely helping people figure out their, like, answer their questions and plan for their financial well-being. I think it's so important. I guess the part I think about my job that I probably dislike the most would be sometimes people say like, oh, he's an actuary, and they make it sound like I'm this special human being. And I just think of myself as a regular person. So I think it's kind of funny when people think I'm like, oh, an actuary, like I'm not a genie. Like I'm just human like everyone else. So I kind of get annoyed sometimes, I guess, when people like talk about me as like, I'm not a celebrity, but like I said, a genie. I just think of myself as someone who knows a lot about insurance products and am beneficial to your client. But I'm not better or different. Like I want to be the same as everyone else. I don't want to be this like mythical creature, I guess.
Any final words or wisdom for people who are interested in the actuarial profession?
Yeah, definitely. Reach out to another student, I would say, first and foremost, because they're closer to the exam process. A lot of people reach out to someone like you or I, and which is great. Like, I try to help as many people as I can, but like, they've added exams since I went through it and they've changed a bunch of them. I don't know the acronyms anymore. So reach out to someone closer to your level, like a year or two ahead of you in university, or someone younger that is like willing to help you out. There's a lot of great resources online now that didn't exist back when like you and I started. And figure out if you're going to like it. Like ask them the questions you want to know. Like, be real. Like, how much effort do you put into this? How much time does it take you to study? What would you do if you fail an exam? Like, ask the questions that you're thinking in your head, because it's better to find out near the beginning that this isn't for you than to be like one exam away and then be like, I don't know if I want to be an actuary. Like, you're going to put in a lot of time. So figure out if it's something that you want now. Having that support system is so important when you're becoming an actuary, like finding a good mentor, having a good group of friends who are writing the same exams as you is so beneficial, because no one really knows what we go through unless you've done it as well. No one understands that, like, you spend six nights a week studying, eating cereal for dinner, and you get to, the one night you have off, you play a sport just because you have to do some kind of activity to stay healthy. Or some, like, and it can be anything just to stay sane, I think. Like, my friends didn't really get it. Like, they'd be like, what do you mean you can't go out this weekend? It's like, no, like, my exam's in a month. Like, I need to study. And they're like, it's in a month. Like, no one, other actuarial people understand it, but people in other professions don't.
Thanks again, Mike, for being here today and talk about your experiences and your journey to become an actuary and also your work as a marketing actuary. So I hope everyone find this video useful, and we will have a second portion next week to talk about career advices, including resume, interview, and then networking. Tune for part 2, and I will see you later. Bye.